Good afternoon students, today I am going to tell about the next concept of magnetism and matter, that is magnetic dipole. In the last class you learned about magnetic field lines and you also came to know different characteristics or properties of magnetic field lines. So now this is the concept called magnetic dipole. I hope you are well familiar with electric dipole. Electric dipole, yes, what is an electric dipole? Electric dipole means it is the system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. Yes, remember the definition of electric dipole is a system of two equal and opposite charges separated by a very small distance. In the same manner here, magnetic dipole is also a system of two equal and opposite poles. Two poles having equal and opposite pole strength. Magnetic dipole is a system consisting of two poles of equal pole strength having opposite nature and separated by a small distance, that is the magnetic dipole. For example, bar magnet is a magnetic dipole. Here bar magnet is also a system which is consisting of two poles. One is a north pole and another one is a south pole, and in between the two there exists a distance of 2L. Distance of 2L, and this distance 2L is called magnetic dipole length. This is called magnetic dipole length, right? So remember that two poles are not exactly situated at the end points of the bar magnet. So here they are somewhat 20% before the 20% before the ending point. So slightly before the end points. So here magnetic field is not same, not acting, it is not uniform throughout the bar magnet or throughout the magnetic dipole. It is here it is maximum across the poles, across north pole and south pole. The strength of the magnetic field or the capacity of attraction or repulsion, it is attraction is maximum near the poles. And as you move from the poles towards the center, the magnetic strength decreases. Here the magnetic strength is maximum at near the poles, and it decreases as you move up far from the poles. So magnetic strength is not unique throughout the magnetic dipole or bar magnet. Yes, what is a magnetic dipole? Magnetic dipole is a system consisting of two poles having equal pole strength but of opposite nature. As the two charges, plus and negative, positive and negative charges are equal and opposite, as that you say, no, in the same manner here also the two poles are having equal pole strengths but opposite in nature. If the pole strength of north pole is positive, pole strength of south pole is negative. It will be negative. So here magnetic dipole, bar example for magnetic dipole is bar magnet, current carrying solenoid. So next comes magnetic dipole movement. Remember the concept of electric dipole movement. Magnetic dipole movement is young. So what is an electric dipole movement? Electric dipole movement, it is the product of magnitude of either charge and separation between the two charges. P equals to Q into 2L. It was learned, you learned in the chapter of electrostatics. Electric dipole movement is the product of magnitude of either charge. See, among the positive and negative, you should choose one charge, and you should take the positive value of that charge and into 2L. There 2L is the separation between the two charges. Here also, here magnetic dipole movement. magnetic dipole moment is defined as magnetic dipole moment is defined as the it is the product of m equals to product of pole strength of the either pole and separation between the two poles. Pole strength of the either pole and separation between the two poles. Pole strength of either pole and separation between the two poles. Here Qm, CQ, what is Qm? Qm is pole strength. Strength of north pole or strength of south pole, Qm. 2L is magnetic dipole length. 2L is magnetic dipole length. Magnetic dipole length. 2L is magnetic dipole length. Here 2L is magnetic dipole length. So what is magnetic dipole momentum? Magnetic dipole moment is the product of pole strength of the either pole and separation between the two poles. So, and now see what is the SI unit for here. See, SI unit of M is, SI unit of M is ampere meter square. Ampere meter square. SI unit of magnetic dipole moment is here for pole strength. Ampere meter is the SI unit for Qm. Qm is the pole strength. SI unit is ampere meter, and for length meter, ampere meter into meter is ampere meter square. Yes, ampere meter square. So electric dipole. What is the SI unit of electric dipole moment? Coulomb meter. There you said coulomb meter is the SI unit of electric dipole moment. But in case of magnetic dipole moment, here the SI unit is ampere meter square. Yes, what is the SI unit? Ampere meter square. See, here next concept is magnetic field strength at a point on the axial line of a magnetic dipole. And another one is magnetic field strength at a point on the equatorial plane of a magnetic dipole. In electrostatics, you learned derivation of these two concepts, but in magnetism and matter, it is not necessary to understand the derivation of the two concepts. You just go through the main formula of axial line derivation and equatorial plane derivation. Remember once, axial line you learned in the first unit. Expression for electric field intensity at a point on the axial line of an electric dipole, and expression for electric field intensity at a point on the equatorial plane of an electric dipole. And you got the expression E axial equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon into 2 p r by r square minus l square whole to the power of square. 1 by 4 pi epsilon into 2 pr by r square minus l square whole square. And for equatorial plane, yes, E equatorial equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon into p divided by r square plus l square whole to the power of 3 by 2. In the same manner, here also you will get the expression. See, this is the magnetic dipole. Here the concept is of magnetic dipole. This is the magnetic dipole. So here north pole and here is south pole, and see this is the axial line. Axial line. You know that axial line is an imaginary line. Axial line is an imaginary line which joins the two poles of the magnetic dipole. It is an imaginary line which joins the two poles of an imaginary line and extends on other side of the dipole. So this is the axial line. So imagine this is the center O and here is point P. Point B, and here the distance between north pole and south pole is 2L. And the distance of the point O to B is R. And the expression for B axial, magnetic field strength B and C are equals to mu naught by 4 pi. Here you should not 1 by 4 pi epsilon, you should not write that one. Instead of that, mu naught by 4 pi into 2 BR, clearly. 1 by 4 pi epsilon badalo mu naught by 4 pi. 2 BR badalo 2 MR, 2 MR divided by R square minus L square whole square. R square minus L square whole square. So here mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi. Mu naught is a magnetic permeability of free space. Magnetic permeability of free space. Mu naught by 4 pi is equals to 10 to the power of minus 7. Mu naught by 4 pi raised to 10 to the power of minus 7. M is the magnetic dipole moment. R is the distance. This distance. And L is the length of the magnetic dipole. Here see L. L, this is L and this is L. So for a short magnet, if the magnet is too short, for a small magnet, here one thing you should understand, R square is very much greater than L square. For a short magnet, this distance becomes very much greater than this L. Length of the dipole, O to S L, O to N L. So here R square is very much greater than L square. So you can ignore L square from the formula. So it becomes B axial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into 2 M R divided by ignoring L square. If you make it as 0, R square whole square becomes R to the power of 4. 1 R here, R cancels, so you will get B axial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into 2 M divided by R cube. 2 M by R cube. 2 M by R cube. This is the expression for magnetic field strength at a point on the axial line of a magnetic dipole. So here, see. Equatorial plane, this is the magnetic dipole, north pole and south pole. So here length is 2L. Length is 2L. So here let PBA point at a distance of R from the center of the magnetic dipole. So here due to north pole, here the magnetic field is repelled. So B1, this is B1. Due to south pole, so B2. South pole is treated as negative. It is having negative pole strength. It is positive pole strength. So B1, B2, this is a resultant magnetic field B, 2 theta. So here see 2 theta. So expression B equatorial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into mu naught by 4 pi into mu naught by 4 pi into M divided by R square plus L square, R square plus L square whole to the power of 3 by 2. R square plus L square whole to the power of 3 by 2. So B equatorial is equals to mu naught by 4 pi into M divided by, see here, for a short magnet, here this is the main expression. Expression is B equatorial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into R square plus L square over to the power of 3 by 2. For a short magnet, if the magnet is too small, for a short magnet here R square is too much greater than L square, therefore ignore L square from the denominator, you will get B equatorial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into M divided by R square whole to the power of 3 by 2. R square whole to the power of 3 by 2. These two cancel. So what you have left with? B equatorial equals to mu naught by 4 pi into m divided by r to the power of mu. Mu naught by 4 pi into m divided by r to the power of 3. These are the direct expressions. No need of thinking about derivation. Derivations are not asked in your examination. They may ask the direct formulas for axial line of magnetic dipole, equatorial plane of magnetic dipole. So these are the direct expressions for axial and for equatorial. If the magnet is too short, if the magnet is a very small magnet, then this will be the expressions. Okay, watch this video for 2 times. You will definitely get an idea about the magnetic dipole moment, expressions for axial line of a magnetic dipole, and equatorial plane of a magnetic dipole. Have a nice day.